What's with Becca's ID? Why does it say Isabella Acosta?
Why not? That's her real name after all.
You should have asked me about it first.
She's my daughter, Sarah.
Kara, she's my daughter too. I've been her mother longer than you have.
Just because I agreed for you to be with her, it doesn't mean you decide what's good for her.
I snuck inside Alex's room earlier, and I saw she has a stash of money hidden in there.
Becca, I'm sorry, okay? Because there are some things I do that might make you feel sad. But I don't want you to be sad, sweetie, and I'm willing to do anything to make you
happy. That witch hasn't gone far yet. Let's follow her. We need to get ahead of her.
Before she starts to suspect that
we know she's keeping a secret.
Alex, who was that man you were talking to earlier? Why did he give you money?
For my sideline. I hope you stop putting me on the spot. They won't find anything on me. They can suspect me all they want, but they can't prove anything.
What will you do if they tell your brother?
That's okay. I can easily make an excuse.
Leave my son alone! The last thing I want for him is to waste his time with a pathetic kid.
You
are crossing the line! Get her out of here! Leave while I can still control myself, because if I lose my temper, I might forget she's your mother.
Becca's enthusiasm seems to be returning. She even joined the poster-making
contest.
Great. And not only that, Hannah's advisor also said that Hannah volunteered to be the class representative.
How's your investigation going?
There's only one staff left I haven't questioned yet, ma'am. She's the nurse that became Lucille's attendant.
I don't care no matter where she is. Go find her. I need to talk to her immediately.
Apparently, Dina has a sibling.
Okay, look for him. He might know where Dina is.
Sada, what are you doing?
I'm here because today is Becca's contest, right? The kid called me herself.
Why have an agreement in the first place?
Where's Alex? She didn't come with you?
She's always absent at the foundation anyway. You know what I think, Seb? You should probably be more aware of where your sister goes all the time.
Who is your favorite hero? You have 1 hour to draw. Timer starts now.
Why hasn't Becca started drawing
yet? Maybe she's looking for Sarah.
Here, be sure to list this all down. Julio, are you okay?
Have you finished everything I asked?
I've collected all the remaining debts. I loaned out a big amount too. The guy gave me this house as collateral. So if it happens that he continues to lose, we'll be making a lot of money.
That's good to hear.
I'm sorry about this. I mean, I know you've got a lot on your plate. And the problems I have with my brother and the others have only added to that. But don't worry about it. When Sarah finally goes to prison, I promise all this will come to an end.
And after that, what happens then?
Then I'll finally be happy. Because that means I can start a new life. I can start a new life with you. I'll do anything you want me to do, Julio. I'm willing to do everything. I owe you a huge debt of gratitude. Don't think for one second I've forgotten that. I will find a way to pay you back. I just need you to make me a promise. That you won't abandon me. Because I need you in my life, Julio. I need you, I really do.
I just wish that you could be of more help to me than a burden.
Promise. Please let me do what I can to take care of you. Because I know it hasn't been easy. It's not easy to handle everything you do when you do it all alone. That's why I'm here for you. I'm always here. Let me be the one you can share your burdens with. I promise you can trust me. I would never, ever betray you, Julio.
Thank you, Dustin. And our next artwork is from a grade 2 pupil, Isabella Acosta. Who was the hero that you chose to draw, Isabella?
My favorite hero is my mama, Sarah Suarez.
Why is she your favorite hero, Isabella?
I know that she's not like the usual heroes. Those that we read about in our school books are like those who risk their lives for our country. But I know one thing, my mama is a hero. Because I know what she did. I saw how she made so many sacrifices for me. I might not be her real daughter, but she still loved me. She took care of me and protected me. And her love is what will remain in my heart.
Thank you so much, Isabella Costa. And now our next artwork. From grade 1 pupil, Hannah Acosta. Why did you show us your drawing, Hannah?
But teacher...
What's wrong?
I think Becca and I have the same drawing. She just went ahead of me.
Oh, that's all right. Just explain your work, okay?
I chose to draw my favorite hero, my mom. She's Kara Acosta. She was the one who worked hard to save me from the people who wanted to hurt me, and I saw how she really tried to save me so I wouldn't have to suffer with them. And also, even when I'm bad, she never gets tired of loving me. So for me, my mother is my favorite hero.
Banjo, why are you still here?
I thought Sarah said Becca had a contest at school.
I decided not to go, Cynthia. Sarah doesn't want me there.
Did you two have a fight?
Not really. But she just told me that I shouldn't hold out hope.
Banjo, you know about everything that Sarah's going through. I mean, you should understand she doesn't have time for any of this, to concern herself with your feelings for her or even Edward's feelings.
But Cynthia, I've been helping her out precisely so that the problems will be out of the way. And then, maybe she'll finally see my worth. But then, I don't think she wants my help anymore.
Banjo, you know what? If you really love her, you need to respect that. And you need to learn some patience.
I'm willing to wait for a long time for Sarah. I would do everything for her.
But Banjo, listen to me. I know you're very determined, but please don't put your own life at risk. I'm not stopping you from loving Sarah. But I hope you keep in mind that there are still other people who love you too. I'm still here. You're the only family I've got left, you know, and I wouldn't be able to bear it if something bad happened to you.
I can't believe the both of you did that. You made us all cry, you know.
But it's true, Itoy. Mom is my hero. I was going to draw all of
our
you.
Our third place winner, Dustin Orlando.
Oh, it's that girl.
What did he draw? Wow.
I wonder who's going to win next. I hope it's Hannah or Becca.
Oh, you were supposed to draw all of us? So why didn't you then?
Because you wouldn't
fit. Oh, that's
fit.
True.
Our second place winner, Hannah Acosta.
Oh, wow. Hannah! Hannah, you won!
Congratulations!
Congratulations,
Hannah! Oh, wow, I told you!
Oh, Becca, stay with your grandma. Hannah, show us that smile. Smile, dear. Wow!
Give me a smile, Hannah. One, two, three. All right, got it.
Come on, let's go.
My grandchild
is such a talented girl.
And for our first
Good
place
job,
winner,
Good
for
job,
the poster-making contest, Isabella Acosta.
Oh! Yeah. Wow. We won! Back here. We won!
Come on, let's go. Go on, darling. Go on up there.
What?
Your mom's right there, you see? It's okay, go on. She'll go with you.
I don't want to.
What? What?
Becca?
Mama! Mama, you came to see me?
Of course I did.
Will you put my medal on me?
I think Kara should be the one to do it.
But Mama, I drew you on my poster. Did you see? Come on. Let's go, Mama.
Oh!
Thank you, ma'am. Are you okay? What's bothering you?
It's nothing.
Come on, you can tell me. I might be able to help. What is it?
It's about Patricia. Ever since she met that guy, Paolo, she stopped listening to me.
I'm really sorry. I should have known that guy wasn't trustworthy.
My dilemma now is if I become stricter with my sister, she might rebel against me.
Why don't you talk to her? Just explain everything. The reason you're being strict is that you're only trying to protect her.
Do you think that I'm doing the right thing?
Of course you are. Patricia is still so young, so she needs someone to guide her in the right direction. And especially that age? Oh yeah, I can say this for sure because I was like that. My brother was strict with me too.
What happened then? How did you get here?
Because of Kara. Ever since she and her pathetic family came into our lives, my brother and I drifted apart. That's what you should never do to Patricia. Don't you dare neglect her. You can see what happened to me. Here's the chicken. Careful. Shall we eat?
There's pizza.
Yes,
you want
Daddy.
Some?
Go on and eat. Kara. I'll be right back. Seb, you're in charge. I should go. I shouldn't be here anyway. It's all right. You guys should celebrate. It doesn't really matter. You're already here. Besides, if you leave now, Becca might look for you. Well, I'll just find a way to explain. And what are you going to tell her? That I was the one that told you to leave, all because of our agreement? I don't have a choice now, do I? You can't expect me to lie to her. Sara, you always had a choice. You had a choice to go home when I asked you earlier, but you didn't do it. You still stayed. Is it so hard for you to give me respect? Now, wait a minute. I have been sticking to our agreement. I had no intention of showing myself to the child. Well, Sara, maybe you're just too selfish. You're always taking advantage of the situation because you know that Becca will choose you. Listen, Kara, don't make me out to be the bad guy. What else do you want? I already left Becca here with you and I kept my distance. I hardly get to see her. Is that what you call selfish? Listen, you're going off on me because Becca would rather be with me. It's not my fault if she doesn't like you. Thank you.
I know. Don't worry about it. It's just a misunderstanding, sweetie.
Please, that's enough. I could hear you two fighting because of me again. About who I'll go with and who I'll stay with. It's always like that.
Becca, I'm sorry.
Honey, I'm sorry.
I love you both so much. But if you're going to keep fighting all the time, I won't go with either of you.
Oh, it's a party. Why, what's this for?
We competed in a skull contest on Alex. I actually won second place. Look at my medal.
Very good.
Alex, can we talk outside right now? Come on. Alex, where have you been?
At the foundation.
Tell me the truth. I know you weren't there. I also know that you've been missing work a lot lately.
I have a job on the side. I'm busy with something else.
Is that really it? Then what's all this that Itoy's told me? That you bought a lot of expensive things? You have that much money? Where is it coming from?
So he was the one who told on me.
That's not an answer. Where did you get the money?
I said I've been working. So I buy and sell designer bags. There's nothing wrong with that.
That's why you've been neglecting the foundation? Because of money? Look, Alex, if you no longer have time to fulfill your duties, you should have just told me.
The foundation doesn't pay much.
Alex, no one's forcing you to stay and work there. If you wanted to leave, you should have said so. Did you realize you were showing the staff that it's okay for you not to show up? Why would that be? Because you're my sister? It shouldn't be that way, Alex.
I didn't want anyone there to think that.
But that's what you've been showing them. Alex, it's for the best. If you stop working at the foundation from here on out, go ahead and focus on that other job. I don't want people there to start thinking that I'm condoning your actions.
Hey, you tattletale! Explain that to me!
Hey, yourself! What's wrong with you? You're so disrespectful!
You're the disrespectful one! How dare you talk smack about me to my own brother!
What's wrong? All I had ever told him was the truth. Nobody has a clue what you've been up to. Of course we're getting suspicious. I mean, who knows? What sort of depravity you have gotten yourself into just to get money? I can tell by the way you look. You'd fit right in with the rest of evil.
How dare you say that to me? Come here and let me stitch your mouth shut now!
Stop!
Alex! Hey, Alex! Please don't do that to me!
Don't touch me!
Please.
This is none of your business!
Alex! Oh! Laura! Laura, are you okay? Look what you've done! Have you no shame that you would hurt anyone, even a woman old enough to be your mother?
Well, that's what she gets for meddling in my business, just like you did!
Oh, are you threatening me? Do you think I'm afraid of you? I may be old, but I can fight back!
Really? Really? What?
Can you two stop it already? Please, Alex, how about you act with some respect?
Some respect? Why would any of you deserve my respect? It's not like you're part of my family!
We've always treated you like part of our family. You're the one who keeps rejecting the idea.
You think you're so great. What is it about you anyway? Don't you realize we're all the same here? Leeching off of the same household? Especially you. You're way too old to be dependent on a young married couple.
Alex!
Have some self-respect.
Alex!
Seb.
Mother, are you okay?
Seb, I'm so glad you're here. Look, she shot your mother-in-law.
Seb, they were the ones who started it.
Alex, I didn't raise you to be disrespectful. They're my family. If you refuse to respect the people in this house, then I think you should leave.
Are you taking their side over me again, huh?
No one's taking sides. Alex, how many times have I told you you're not my only family? Kara is my wife. Her family is my family. You have no right to disrespect, much less hurt any of them.
And yet they have the right to speak ill of me to you? They're making it appear that I've been doing something wrong, when that's not true!
If what you're saying is true, then you should understand them! They're part of our family!
Never! They are not my family, and I will never consider them to be my family. I only ever tried to get along with them for your sake, you know? They're the reason our relationship is falling apart. Ever since these people came into our lives, it's been hopeless. I feel like I've lost you. What's going on in here?
Nothing. Mother. It's nothing.
Stay with your mother.
Hey, what is this? You guys are so noisy. What's going on?
Listen, Sarah. Alex tried to hurt your mother.
What? How dare you? Why did you try to hurt my mother?
That's enough.
How dare you lay a finger on her? What?
Sarah.
I'm sorry, Alex, but this is it. I've warned you so many times before not to start trouble in this house. You've worn out my patience.
But, Seb, you can't.
Get your things now.
Seb, please,
get your things right now. You can't live in this house anymore.
Okay. If that's what you want, then fine. I've always known they were more important to you than I ever was. Why don't you all just rot together? I'm so tired of trying to adjust to people I shouldn't even be wasting my time with. I hate you. Get out of here before I hurt you.
To confirm that it was you who kidnapped Becca.
Oh, come on, Sarah. I really don't have time for this right now. Get out of here.
No, I'm not going to leave until I find something.
Hey! Hey! What do you think you're doing? Don't touch my things! Don't touch that! I told you to get out already! Leave me alone! Just stop it! Get your hands off of my things!
I'm not listening to you!
Hey, hey, leave what's me happening
alone.
Here?
Seb, could you please get Sarah out of here? I'm packing my things like you said, and she won't leave me alone!
I refuse to leave this room until I find what I'm looking for!
Oh, over there! I saw a huge wad of cash over here with
eyes! You can't just go through my things like that!
Why? What are you so afraid of? I'm just going to show them that you have money hidden right in that cabinet! Isn't that something suspicious? Huh? That might as well be dirty money!
Shut up! That's not even true! I don't
if
have
you're
money
you're not
like
hiding
that.
Anything, open the cabinet!
Fine then. Look through it. Go ahead. Gang up on me, why don't you? Let's see if you find anything.
There's nothing here. I saw the money in a big bag. Maybe she moved the money.
All right, Ito.
Nothing.
Sarah, please. Give Alex time to pack her things. Just let her leave in peace.
Peace? Okay. I won't interfere or touch her things, but I won't leave this room.
I have received updates regarding Lucille's former nurse.
Where is she now?
She's currently based in Dubai. Although, I was able to talk to her family, and they told me that she's taking time out to come home for a vacation.
And when is she arriving?
The day after tomorrow. The only thing left for us to do at this point is to wait.
I hope so. She might be able to shed light on everything that had happened. And that way, we might be able to prove that my daughter had nothing to do with any of this.
Mother, are you absolutely sure you're okay?
Yes, don't worry about me. I'm fine.
Mother, I'm so sorry about what Alex did. I never would have thought that she could hurt you like that.
Seb, it wasn't just she was violent to your mother-in-law. She also said some pretty hurtful things to us.
What is going on with her?
Seb, I'm sorry to say this, but I honestly think you did the right thing in making Alex leave. I myself wouldn't be able to help but react to what she said to Mother.
I can't believe you even waited this long to kick her out. I still believe she might have had something to do with when your daughter went missing.
Sarah, please don't bring this up now. The issue here is Alex's mistreatment of Mother. Don't drag Isabella into this right now.
Cut it out. Are you really still playing dumb here? Itoy just said he saw a lot of money hidden in Alex's room. It's not impossible she paid people to make you suffer.
Well, as far as I can remember, you didn't find money among her things. So please, just stop it. I won't blindly believe every single thing you say. I still need proof. And Sara, don't forget, you haven't proven your own innocence to us.
Seb. Sara, come on, that's enough. What's the point in talking if you're just going to fight? The hearing is close enough, we'll be able to determine who's telling the truth.
Oh, I have a feeling Alex is in shady business.
You promise, Mama? Everything's fine?
Uh-huh. I'm sorry about that. Sweetie.
What was happening, Mom? Why was everyone making so much noise?
Hannah, you see... Well, your Aunt Alex, she had to leave the house.
She did? Why would she leave us?
Because... Unfortunately, your Aunt Alex did something bad to your grandma and to Itoi. So for them not to hurt each other more, we decided it would be for the best for her to leave the house. Hey, why the long face?
But Aunt Alex has always been nice. So why did you make her leave?
Listen to me, Hannah. That's where you're sorely mistaken. She's probably nice to you because you're a kid. But ever since I've met her, she's done nothing more than cause trouble for our family.
Hannah, listen. At the right time, when your Aunt Alex has changed, she's more than welcome to come back to our house. But for now, it's better that she goes to live somewhere else.
Come on, you kids should go to bed now.
Becca, good night, okay?
You know, I bet you'll have the sweetest dreams. You won first place today. My daughter's the best, isn't she?
Hannah, congratulations as well. And Becca, congratulations. You made your mom so proud.
I'm really happy. Because we have world peace today. I wish we would always have world peace in this family.
Of course we will. I swear.
Of course. Go on now. Get some rest.
Good night.
Good night.
Alex. What is this? I get it. They kicked you out of the house, huh? Why?
It's all because of Kara's family.
Give us some privacy. So much for looking out for you. Your brother can be such a jerk. At least you'll have somewhere to stay.
Are you saying you'll let me stay at your place?
Have you lost your mind? I can't do that. My sister's there. What will I tell her? The house I bought back for you is still yours. You should stay there.
Kara, I should go ahead. And I wanted to thank you for today. I know it wasn't supposed to be my day with Becca. Sorry about that.
I should thank you. I'm sorry if I got a little uptight about our agreed schedule, but the way Becca was glowing today was just different. And I've seen the special kind of happiness you give her. These past few days, I could really tell that the situation has been difficult for her. It's like her world has stopped spinning.
I'm pleased to see you understand her situation. Honestly, I'm struggling to accept all of this. Sometimes I forget I'm not really her mother. I know I have a tendency to be overbearing in being her mom, and so I have ended up going too far in hurting you. I'm sorry about that.
I do try to keep it fair between us, even if it hurts me, even when it's hard. I just try to keep in mind that nothing would be worse than seeing Becca's heart broken again. I'd do anything to save her from that.
So, we're even. We both made mistakes.
I like it better this way, not fighting with you. And it's better for Becca to see us getting along. Besides, we're too old to keep fighting.
I know, that's exactly why I want to prove my innocence. It would be nice for all of us to get along.
Ma'am, everything here has been fixed and cleaned up for you.
Thanks, mister.
All right. Excuse me.
Just because my brother chose you over me doesn't mean you won.
If you think I'm going to leave your family in peace, Kara, you're sorely mistaken. I would love to see how you'll treat Sarah once it's proven that she kidnapped Becca. This fight is far from over. I've only just begun making sure that you will pay for everything you've done to me. You're all going to get what you deserve soon enough.
Hey, Patricia Hernandez, what in the world is going on with you? What's that look on your face? That's a comedy, right?
Well, you see, Nanny, I can't understand my brother. He's getting to me. First, he made me leave the foundation. Okay, I did that. And then I told him I wanted to try and work at the travel agency. But he still wouldn't agree. He didn't like the idea. Is it so wrong to want to help out? I've been itching to do something more than just stay home.
Yes. I can see how that can be quite a problem for my little girl. But you know what? You should be grateful that that's the biggest and only problem you have to face. Most other people your age aren't even given a choice. They have to work to survive. You have the freedom to sit here and do nothing all day and you're complaining?
But Nanny, wouldn't you get sick of just being home all day, every day? Day in and day out, it's always the exact same thing. It's a far cry from all the work that I did at the foundation. At least, out there, even when I'm exhausted, I'm fulfilled. Because there's fulfillment in helping other people.
Are you absolutely sure that that's the only reason you would want to go back to the foundation? For all I know, there's someone there you're missing. I bet it's because of that guy. Paolo? You miss Paolo, don't you? You miss the guy.
See, that's the problem. That's what I was talking about.
Yes.
You know what's weird? Julio snuck that into the conversation. I sat down and talked to him because I wanted to work at the travel agency, right? I mean, what did Paolo have to do with any of that? And you know what else he told me? He told me that I have stopped showing him respect ever since the first time that I met Paolo.
Are you so sure that Paolo hasn't made a change in that way?
That's ridiculous. Of course not. That's not the problem. Although, you know, it's strange to me. I don't get why Julio has been against the idea of me working in the travel agency since the start. Do you think he's hiding something from me?
So what do you suggest we do now, knowing that we can't find any evidence against Lucille or Alex?
Don't worry, Miss Suarez. I have good news for you.
What is it?
I went to the police station earlier. And what I know now is that they were trying to find someone, and that someone would be the brother of Dina Nicolás.
And? Is that supposed to be helpful to my case?
Yes. There's a possibility that the brother could tell us where Dina is. And once we find Dina, her testimony could be exactly what we need to have your case acquitted.
Hold on, wait a second. How come we've never heard about this? We could have looked for that guy and we might have found him sooner.
It appears that the party deliberately withheld the information about Dina's brother from all of you.
But why would they do that? It would be easier if they were helpful.
I think they still consider Sara their opponent in this case.
You know, madam, I have a strong feeling that Sab still doesn't trust me.
If that's the case, then we should reach out to Dina's brother. Do you know where we can find him?
I got information from the police. We know she has a brother. And I got a hold of his address. You can start with that at least. It would be ideal if you can get in touch with him before the first hearing starts.
Okay, we'll try to get to him. I'd do anything I can to prove my innocence, and I'll make sure he joins us on our side.
I'll go with you, Sarah. I'm going to help you find that guy.
You don't need to. I can do this.
I'm worried about Alex. She hasn't been answering any of my calls.
It could be that she's still mad at you. But you have to remember, Seb, Alex is old enough to take care of herself. If you're worried about her daily expenses, I'm sure she has her savings for that.
I just hope I don't end up regretting what I did. I promised her that we would never be apart, and I broke that promise.
Seb, don't blame yourself. None of this is your fault. I'm sorry to say this, but it's Alex's own actions that led to this decision. You did all you could to help her. Haven't you been trying to talk to her all along?
Yes, you're right. I know this is the right thing to do, being the head of the family. If your dad was here, I knew he'd do the same thing, especially if he saw what she did.
I think you're right about that. She really crossed the line with what she did to Mother. Looking back on what just happened, I know being around those kind of fights will not do us any good. And I think it's about time we make Alex realize that what she does is harmful to people around her.
Alex, I'm glad you're finally awake.
What brings you here? Oh, wait, have you had breakfast yet? Let me prepare something for you.
Oh, no, you don't have to. No need. Don't worry about me. So, what's your plan?
I have a lot of ideas for Kara. As for plans for my own life, I don't know yet.
How is that an answer?
Because I was thinking that it's a good thing I'm here and not living with them anymore. This is much better. I don't have to hide anything.
So what is your plan?
I'm going to live here in my own house and start a new life. This is all too familiar, isn't it? That's right. This is where I'll put my plans together to destroy Kara and her family.
Would you like to get a job at my travel agency?
Huh? Is that a serious offer?
Yeah. I'm the only person you can count on right now. And besides, I would like to still have some use for you.
I've been telling you this for a long time. I'm all yours. Why would I turn you down, Julio, now that you're helping me out with everything you've got? Thank you. I really don't know what I would have done without you.
Itoy?
Laura? Look at how perfect the weather is. And after it rained down on us all night, it's like the rain wanted to come down and wash this house clean of all the remaining negativity. Isn't it so nice to have a day like this? That's stress-free, worry-free, truly free.
Hey, you ought to tone it down. Seb might hear you.
Well, so what? I said negativity, but I didn't say Alex's name, did I?
Come on.
You know me well. You know what I mean. But Laura, come on. Let's just bask in the joy of what has happened. Finally, we can be free from that witch, Alex. She no longer lives in this house. I refuse to forgive her for what she did to you, you know?
I can't help but feel bad for Seb. It must have been very difficult for him to come to that decision about his sister.
Oh, don't think about that. I'm telling you that it's great that he has finally managed to kick that girl out of here. His sister was a terrible person. Laura, Alex being kicked out here was long overdue. If I were you, I'd feel a lot safer now knowing Alex isn't here to mess our lives up.
I know what you mean. Yes, I do feel a lot more secure knowing we're not sharing a house with her anymore. She'll be away from my kids, as well as my grandchildren. What will happen to Sarah?
To Sarah?
But why? Your daughter was the one who had always hoped that witch Alex would leave us alone.
No, that's not what I meant. You don't understand. Now that she's not here, how are we going to find evidence that shows Alex is involved in Sarah's case?
Oh, I see.
It will be impossible to investigate her. She has more freedom to make her moves now.
Wait, Laura. Have you tried talking to Barbara again lately? For all we know, that woman may have new information on her hands. She might be keeping it from you. You know how she is.
All right, calm down. I'm glad you reminded me. I'm going to call her and ask her myself. I'll be back.
Yes, Rain, come down and cleanse us!
You already know what you're going to do?
I do.
Just because you moved out of your brother's house doesn't mean that you're safe. Remember, all this trouble began only because they were starting to suspect you.
What's the big deal? I got out of it.
It might be a bigger problem now that you're away from your brother. How are you going to know if they found anything they can use against you now? How will you know what to do if they're always one step ahead of you?
Julio, I would not have gotten away with it for so long if I weren't any good at this. Trust me, I'm going to figure something out.
Excuse me, I hope you don't mind, but do you know anyone named Dante Nicholas?
Oh no, I'm sorry, miss, I can't help you, I'm just new
here. I've never heard that name before, ma'am.
Thanks anyway. Mister, would you know of a Dante Nicholas, the brother of Dina? I heard he lives somewhere around here.
How much is that information worth?
Are you serious? Why would I pay you? I'm just asking if you know that guy or not.
Joey, leave her alone. Hey, miss, who is it
you're
looking
for? Go talk to her instead.
It's Dante Nicholas. They tell me he's a brother of Dina. I heard that he might live somewhere in this area.
Oh, is that so? You could try asking people around the corner. They're likely to be familiar with the residents. They might be able to help you.
Thanks for your help, miss.
Okay.
At least she was helpful to me.
You see?
Yeah, go on.
Huh?
Hey, beautiful.
That's my girl, man.
She's not yours. I saw her first.
Oh, no.
She's mine.
She's mine.
What happened?
What are you doing here?
Get away from my girl.
Don't touch her.
Didn't
I tell you guys to stop drinking?
Hey, get these guys away from me.
The police men have been giving us trouble.
I didn't do anything.
Come on.
That's enough from you guys already.
Take them.
Come on.
We were just drinking, man.
What is that? What are you doing here? Did you get hurt?
You're asking me if I got hurt? You're the one who was harassed by those jerks.
Wait a minute. Were you following me?
Of course I was. I couldn't let you come here by yourself.
You shouldn't have done that. You never listened to me.
Sarah, what happened? Are you okay?
What are you doing here? Did you think you'd come to my rescue? How did you even know I was here? Is it too much to ask that you two stop following me?
And what are you doing here anyway?
Sarah, I was able to speak to Anthony about Dina's brother. I'm here because I'm looking for him too. I'm only trying to help you. I won't let you search for him by yourself, and especially not in a neighborhood like this.
Edward, listen to me. I appreciate it, but you've done enough. You've already given me a lawyer. Are you offering me a bodyguard? I won't be able to pay you back, so stop it.
You know, she's right. You've gone a little overboard. I think you should just turn around and head home. Your mom might be looking for you. Your old tricks won't work on Sarah.
Hey.
I mean, why are you... What are you trying to say, huh?
Stop it! Hey, you guys, stop. That's enough. What's wrong with you two? Are you going to help me out, or would you rather go home? Are you really going to start fighting now? You're no better than those jerks on the street earlier. Can you not? I've dealt with enough troublemakers today.
Honey, promise to finish the food I packed for you. You shouldn't waste food.
Yes, Grandma.
I'm coming.
Your gate was wide open, so I let myself in.
Please, come on in. Thank you for coming.
I just came from a meeting with my private investigator, and that's what brings me over here.
Was he able to give further updates on Isabella's pin? Please sit down.
The investigator was able to talk to the nurse from the hospital. He thinks she might have given Lucille the pin. At this point, we're just waiting for her to fly back to the country so we can meet her and talk to her.
She might also be able to serve as a witness in court to help clear Sarah's name.
Don't be too sure of that, Laura. None of us have any idea what she'll say just yet. We should just be prepared. Because I know one of us is going to get hurt.
Or maybe neither of us will.
And how? Are there other suspects? It's not just between Lucille and Sarah?
Yes, there are. There's Alex, too. Sarah has a strong feeling that she had something to do with what happened.
But she's Seb's sister, isn't she?
Yes, that's her. But she has done some things in the past that have given us reason to suspect her.
If she was indeed behind all this, I will do everything I can to make sure she pays. It wasn't just Sarah's life she ruined, but my daughter's life as well. And that is not something that I can forgive.
Please give me an update after you've talked to the nurse.
Aunt Alex!
Hannah! How have you been?
I'm okay, Aunt. What about you? How are you? You didn't even say goodbye to me before you left.
Oh, I'm so sorry, Hannah. It all happened so suddenly.
My mom told me that they had to make you leave the house because you started a big fight with Grandma and Momshi. Is that what happened?
It's not. None of that is true. Don't believe what they tell you. They're the ones doing bad things to me. They're always ganging up on me.
Why would they do that to you?
I don't know. But what I do know is that it's your wicked Aunt Sarah who's behind all this.
Why is she so mean to you?
It makes me real sad, too. Because Seb has been really mad and won't talk to me at all. Hannah, do you think you can help me? Can you help me be okay with my brother again?
How do I help?
You can tell me everything that happens, whatever goes on in the house, like how they're doing back there. That way, I'll know when it's the right time to talk to Seb.
I can do that.
Today? Do you think I should go see Seb today?
Maybe not today.
But why not?
Grandma had a visitor today. I saw her talking to an old woman.
An old woman? Who was it?
I don't know her. But I saw her hair was all white. She was pretty and she looked rich too.
What did they talk about?
I didn't hear everything they talked about. But I think I heard something about a nurse in a mental hospital. And I think they sounded like they were mad at you.
Give this to Lucille De La Rosa and tell her it's from her granddaughter.